Why use a virus to cure cancer? Well, the reason is simple. We can design a virus which is completely disabled so it cannot infect normal human cells, but can only divide inside cancer cells. Now, these oncolytic viruses work just like any virus, so let me explain. A virus simply is inanimate. It doesn't live, it doesn't breathe, viruses don't use energy, and in a sense, you can't kill a virus because it's not a living thing. Viruses are simply machines. Microscopic, atomic, nanobot-type machines. They have a capsule which protects the genetic code inside the virus from the environment. They have legs. They have feet. Feet which are designed to latch onto human cells. And at the inside the virus is genetic code. Genetic code is the language of life. It's what makes your hair red or brown or black. It's what gives you the size of your nose. Genetic code is what gives us language ability as a human species. Genes are the universal language of life. And the genetic code that we have in humans is fundamentally written in the same way as the genetic code in mosquitoes, in earthworms, in bacteria. That's the miracle of life, that you can take a gene from a human being, for insulin, for example, and put it into a microbe and grow those microbes in the laboratory, and they will grow pure human insulin for you. This is the extraordinary thing that we can do with genes. Now, a virus is just a gene-delivering machine. That's what it is. And when we alter the genes inside a virus, we can change the genetic code, the commands that we're going to give to cells when they're infected. So the virus is injected into the body, either directly into a tumour or into the blood supply. Of course, if you do it into a vein, you're going to probably need to use many more virus particles. And when the virus touches cancer cells, it delivers its genetic code, and the genetic code is activated. Why? Because these cancer cells have a particular characteristic that the virus needs. These viruses, these oncolytic viruses, have been deliberately damaged in the laboratory. They are ineffective in normal cells. But inside cancer cells, they are highly activated, highly effective at taking command and control of a cancer cell and instructing it to make more virus particles. So that's why oncolytic viruses are so fascinating to researchers and why there's now such intense interest amongst oncologists around the world in how they can use oncolytic viruses to treat their own patients alongside all the things they are already doing, such as surgery, chemotherapy, and radiotherapy.